So for today's video, I want to talk about something that's incredibly important for any musician, not just a guitar player, and that is how your instrument sounds dramatically affects your performance. Whether you're in the studio or you're playing live, the feedback that you get through your own ears is incredibly important to you because you want to sound good. And if you hear yourself sounding good, can actually help you play better or even take you to a new creative place. For a quick and silly example, if I take one of my electric guitars and I play it unplugged, I still know the song I'm gonna play and I know all of the chords and scales I'm gonna use, regardless of whether or not I'm plugged in, but the way that I respond to it as a musician is different. So here's an unplugged electric guitar. And now take, for example, an amp that I really like and really like how it sounds. Trying to play that up for camera's sake. It's just, there is something about that sound and that flavor that just, it just hits differently. It takes me into another place and it's like, yeah, that, more of that, please. So it should be pretty easy to see how good tone can affect performance and how you feel. You saw the dumb faces I made, didn't you? So like I said earlier, this applies to more than just electric guitar. It applies to any musician and whatever instrument they have. And each different kind of tone is actually going to affect your playing differently. So in my case, that was a pretty ballsy lead guitar tone, and it made me really excited and want to shred a little bit on the guitar. If it was a really good clean tone, that would have taken me somewhere else on the guitar. That still could have been a great tone, but it's not going to give me the same inspiration that that big lead tone did. So one of my favorite sounds that I want to share with you guys that's really inspirational to me is using a lot of reverb with a dobro. So this is a dobro. It's actually a Dobro branded Dobro too. But what it is a resophonic guitar. Underneath the fancy metal cover, there is a metal speaker cone basically that the strings and the bridge actually rest on, giving the guitar kind of a unique sound. And it's a really, really cool sound at that. So one thing to note about the Dobro's sound is that because we've got the whole arrangement back here and no big sound hole like most acoustic guitars, it's a fair bit quieter than most acoustic guitars and it doesn't have a whole lot of sustain. And that's particularly true of the metal body ones. This is a wood body Dobro, but there's some that are all metal and they sound kind of dark and dead sounding, which is a really cool sound, but it's a very charactered sound. This Dobro is a little bit more general purpose than a metal bodied one because it can hit more sounds than just that kind of dark sound. But even then, the guitar alone doesn't tend to put me as a player into that cool headspace. So here's what it sounds like just in the room with just the camera mic. Which, it sounds good. It's got a really cool flavor to it, but it's not an exact tone that really grabs me personally. There's something about really wet reverb, adding a longer tail and giving a little bit more sustain to the instrument and really making the bass notes stand out and be important when they're hit rather than everything being a little bit more dull and dark, that really brings out something in me as a player when I play this instrument. To show you this effect in action for Volume 2 of the Railroads Online soundtrack, I figured I would play a new song for you guys that uses this technique. Thank you. Guys enjoyed the fourth song off of the Railroads Online soundtrack volume 2, and I hope you guys enjoyed the subject of today's video, talking about how different sounds and tones can affect you as a musician. And hey, if you're a musician, I'd like to hear what tones inspire you and how they change your plan. Leave them down below in the comments. As always, if you like the video, or Railroads Online, or music production, or any of those sorts of things, leave a comment, subscribe, and like the video. So, we'll see you guys next time.